synchronizing financial markets, many distributed parts of the stock exchange. A presentation by me, Ben Spooner. Quick outline, going over a few topics here. We're going over how high frequency trading affected the stock market, stock market time synchronization history and standards, how the stock market synchronizes its clocks, specific stock exchange clock performances, other challenges that synchronization engineers face, and finally the conclusion. First, high frequency trading and its effect on the stock market. So the growth of a global market means that less money can be made in large, one-at-a-time trades, and it means that more can be made in quick, small trades in order to take advantage of the nuanced trade market. So as computers gained popularity, it meant that in the 1990s, electronic trading began to take place, which is where high-speed computers run trading algorithms that automatically trade based on market conditions. This increased the number of stock exchanges from 3 to 72 in the U.S. High-frequency trading has now necessitated that all exchanges and trading platforms have accurate, high-resolution, consistent timestamps to avoid market fraud and manipulation. So how does it reduce the risk of fraud? Well, I'll give you an example. So let's say that there are many small buyers for one specific kind of stock, but so they are all buying at the same time. Then 0.4 seconds after they all buy, one big buyer comes in and buys all of the stocks before they can. Well, the program says, well, of course I want to sell it to this one guy because I'll make money, more money than off of all of these little guys. The big guy, and that's a short amount of time, raises the stock price and then sells it to all of the little groups of buyers. Now normally this would be considered market fraud, but because if the resolution is too low, it can take place all within one unit of time, and that follows that there's no way to track it, and so the fraud was committed without any way to see it. So if there were smaller intervals of time, then this reduces the windows in which this can happen. So the stock market time synchronization history and requirements. Before high frequency trading, there was a 6 second resolution, but in 1996 this was decreased to 3 seconds to try and account for electronic trading. In 2008 it was reduced to 1 second, and in 2017 it was taken from 1 second to 50 milliseconds for all trades, and it was taken down to 1 microsecond for high frequency trades done by computers. And this is still the current standard for Europe. So, next, looking at the market synchronization process, how the stock market, or the stock exchange, synchronizes its clock. So, there's a standard clock at location A. This is the clock that all the other clocks get the time from. This clock is then relayed through a satellite, piggybacking on a GPS signal to each stock exchange. The time difference, T1, is measured between the clock and the satellite. Then the difference between satellite clock and the market clock is measured, T2. The sum of these differences is the correction given at the market location. You can see that calculation at the bottom of the page. Now we have specific clock performances for the stock exchange. So they use rubidium atomic clocks that operate at 10 megahertz. The phase comparators can measure differences of up to 10 minutes. They also have 30 picoseconds of resolution, and the average error is 100 femtoseconds, or I don't know what the conversion is. Another challenge is time dilation. Satellites move relatively fast compared to the ground, so there is time dilation, which means that the time moves slower for them. Also, the different geographic locations for the satellites and the two locations on the ground means that the gravitational potential is different, which means that by the theory of relativity, it tells us that the time will be experienced differently for those three locations. equations, and the only way to solve that is through general relativity modeling, but that's beyond the scope of this course, and it's kind of magic. So, in conclusion, the essential parts to the stock exchange system is having a reliable standard clock, having a reliable way to calculate propagation delay, and having a way to model other errors.